As she stated before, was it is called Is Food Thy Medicine, and it's basically just, you know, we have so many different diets out there that tell us we should go on high protein, low carb diets, or this is the best way to live and this is the best way to live. So basically for me, my family has had a long history of illnesses, and myself, I've dealt with my weight issues pretty much my whole life. So I really took this paper to kind of try to figure out exactly, just basically being more informed and trying to figure out where should I start, what should I do. And so a couple of the things that I looked up, one of them was a documentary called Forks Over Knives. I don't know if you've ever heard of it. It's a great documentary, so I'm gonna show you a trailer basically on that documentary. And the paper itself was kind of going over the differences between focusing on an animal-based diet and a plant-based diet and the benefits, basically. So I'm going to let you guys see this.
This could be the first generation of children in the United States that lives less than its parents.
I got two pills I take for my diabetes, then I got one for cholesterol, high blood pressure, and then I take Byetta, which is an injectable.
I'm getting really shaky, and I'm sick, and I'm fatigued, and that's when they diagnosed me with hypertension and diabetes.
Obesity, diabetes, heart disease, high blood pressure cost this country more than $120 billion each year.
People are saying, you're crazy. You're a cancer patient. You should be resting. Doctors told me this.
When I had the second heart attack, the doctor said, I should prepare for death.
Heart disease is an absolutely toothless paper tiger that need never, ever exist.
People who were raised in Japan, the Philippines, Korea, China, never had heart disease, prostate cancer, colon cancer, breast cancer, rheumatoid arthritis, multiple sclerosis.
This is the atlas of cancer mortality in China.
Virtually, the Western diet was non-existent. They had no animal products. They had no dairy, no meat.
We learned that we could turn on and turn off cancer growth just by adjusting the level of intake of that protein.
I knew at that point what caused most diseases.
Our national authorities are simply excluding this concept in order to protect the status quo.
With the Western diet, there are going to be 500,000 people in this country this year who will have to have the front half of their body divided, their heart exposed. Some people would call that extreme.
I know of nothing else in medicine that can come close to what a plant-based diet can do.
If you go through life thinking that what happens to you from a health perspective is based on your genes, you're a helpless victim.
I've reversed the diabetes. The diabetes is not coming back.
I just can't understand what it's done to change my life.
Diet is so much more important than anybody ever thought.
To me, the answer is so simple, it's criminal. And it's just people starting to take responsibility for their health and starting to eat more plant-based foods. It's that simple.
So that's the trailer for Forks Over Knives, and they talk a lot about how food really is our medicine, and Hippocrates actually coined that phrase. And so for us to kind of go through all of this now and see how diabetes is a, you know, big, and heart disease and obesity and all of these things, and to think that food, simply food, can be medicine and can cure all of these things is kind of mind-blowing. So with this documentary, I didn't just look at this one. I looked at other ones too, called, one other documentary was called Fat, Sick, and Nearly Dead. And that one is about this gentleman. He went on a 60-day juice diet and basically just consumed fresh juices and for 60 days. And he had a rare autoimmune disease and was able to actually cure that within that time frame. And he was able to lose, they didn't say exactly how much weight he lost, but he lost a significant amount of weight. And he, on his journey as well, was able to get other people on this road, on this journey, and they were also able to see some pretty significant results as well. The biggest thing that I was thinking about with that specific example is that it's kind of hard to think, you know, if you go on a juice diet, of course you're going to lose weight because you're consuming much less calories. If you think of like spinach, you know, you can eat a whole bag of spinach and still not consume as much as a 6 ounce piece of chicken. So that's really easy to see. But as far as the actual, you know, treating of an autoimmune disease, that to me, again, is mind blowing to think of that curing that. So I'm going to show you now some my PowerPoint. You said this black one here? This fell. Thank you.
Do you know how to send it out? Because it's not going to be.
Wait. There it is. Okay, so let's see. So you still can't see it. Okay. So basically, this is a funny picture, but during my research, they found that a lot of the cancers, heart disease, things like that were attributed to eating meat and other animal-based products. And so, like I was saying before, nutrition does play a big role in cancer risk and genetic predisposition. One of the interesting things that they pointed out in one of the documentaries was that sometimes we're genetically predispositioned to have cancer in our genes. But nutrition alone can trigger or can suppress that trigger from actually being able to cause the cancer to actually show. So that's, like I said, that was pretty interesting. So, and then this one here, our bodies naturally produce cholesterol. So we automatically do that. But when we consume dairy and eggs and meat, for instance, then it leads to coronary artery disease, which then, of course, leads to heart bypass surgery if you have too much of it, because you're building up extra cholesterol that your body doesn't actually need. To give you kind of a shocking example, this here is nutrition. So this is one large egg, and it's basically one yolk has basically twice the amount or the same amount as two Burger King Whoppers of cholesterol. So let's see, gosh, sorry guys. Cholesterol, 215 milligrams for one large egg, and then this one here, this is the Whopper, has 95 milligrams. So it's pretty shocking. This here is part of the Forks Over Knives, and kind of the China Study is one of the books that Dr. Campbell, he's one of the doctors that actually shows up in or appears in Forks Over Knives. They did a study, and they found that Dr. Esselstein found that in Japan they had 18 total deaths, and the USA had over 14,000 deaths related to prostate cancer in 1958, and the correlation was eating more animal-based foods in the USA. So they started doing a lot of research and looking at what was affecting it, and then basically once Japan and all of these other countries started adopting more of a Western diet, they started seeing an increase in these types of cancers. And so as I was stating before, a whole food plant-based diet might be the solution to obesity, diabetes, high blood pressure, and certain types of cancers. Dr. Esselstein, he was actually a surgeon, and he used to work with a lot of breast cancer patients back in the 70s, and he did a lot of research and basically came to the conclusion that he didn't want to do that anymore because he was basically just trying to fix the problem once the problem had already been occurring, and he wanted to find a solution to breast cancer before it occurred. And so that's kind of what led him down this path of finding that plant-based diets are ultimately better in preventing those types of cancers. And then this is this is basically the food pyramid that they show in Fat, Sick, and Nearly Dead. And it's the main foundation of it is unlimited vegetables, and then everything else. You rarely, as you can see up at the top, you rarely ever eat animal-based foods. And then at the bottom here, it says that those that consumed this type of diet actually showed the most weight loss ever recorded in medical history, and that was sustained, so it didn't change. As long as they kept that same diet, they kept the same weight, basically. So. And then this is Joe Cross. He's the one I was telling you guys about before, from Fat, Sick, and Nearly Dead. That was him in the beginning with weight, his weight before he started the juicing. And then this is after. So it's a really great documentary. I would definitely recommend that one. And then this here is the breast cancer occurrences depending on your animal intake, your animal-based diet intake. So that's the correlation there. And then I was just being funny. Don't go gaga for meat. So. And then this is Hippocrates, the father of medicine. Let thy food be thy medicine, and let thy medicine be thy food. And one of the other things that I was thinking about when I was working on this project was we do a lot of things nowadays to cure our symptoms. So when we think about like having a headache, for instance, we have a headache and we think, let's pop a pill and let's get it over with and get move on with our days. Instead of thinking, okay, I have a headache, my body's telling me something. My body's telling me I'm tired or I need to step away from the computer for a minute and just go take a nap or something like that. Instead, we pop pills to suppress the symptoms instead of actually fixing it and listening to our bodies. So, like doing all of this research and finding so many different facts about it, it really makes you think how our bodies usually will work to kind of take care of themselves and actually fix whatever's wrong with it without us having to do anything else, without us having to pop pills, etc. So, do you guys have any questions? I guess I'll open it up. Thank you.
Yeah, so now we can, I don't think the other presenter showed up.